God, there is no darkness at all. If we walk in the light as God is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin.
Amen.
Our gathering song is in the Green Hymnal 34, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
together our prayer today.
Stir up your power, Lord Christ, to come. By your merciful protection, awaken us to the threat of many future sins, and keep us blameless until the coming of your new day. For you live and reign with God, our Father, and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first reading is from Isaiah chapter 64. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence, as when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked at your presence. In ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways, but you were angry, and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider we are all your people. We will read Psalm 80 responsively. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, leading Joseph like a flock, shine forth, you that are enthroned up on the cherubim.
In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come to our helpless.
Restore us, O God, let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
O Lord God of hosts, how long will your hand for you?
You have fed them with the bread of tears. You have given them bowls of tears to drink.
You have made us such a rich and rich, and our enemies laugh at us scorn.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
Let your hand be upon the one who is your hand, and the one who has made us honor for yourself.
And so will we never turn away from you. Give us life, that we may call upon your name.
Restore us, Lord, our God of hosts, let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
Our second reading is taken from 1 Corinthians. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you, because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech, and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you are called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Please rise for our Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "In those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey. When he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. Let us pray. O Lord, as we wait your coming, let us ever be mindful that it could be today. Let us live this day in expectant hope, an anticipation of that glorious day when we will see your glory face to face. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. This is the beginning of our church year, this first Sunday of Advent. It is a time that we as Christians expectantly wait and prepare for the celebration of Jesus, of the birth of Jesus. But it is also a time when we anticipate the coming again of Jesus Christ. Have you ever thought about how much time you spend waiting? We wait in lines at stores, in restaurants. We wait for someone to come, and maybe sometimes we wait for them to leave. We wait for internet connections, for programs to start, for meetings to begin and end, for our little ones to walk and talk. We wait for meals to get done, for family and friends to call, for recovery from illness or surgery. We all wait. And we remember waiting 3 years ago during the pandemic for when we would be able to return doing what we would like to do. Our lives seem to be a time of waiting for something or other, doesn't it? This is the time we are preparing for school and Sunday school programs. The children are excited about what gifts they're going to receive. We're planning meals, travel schedules. Traditions of big family gatherings are planned, decorating, baking, gift buying, and wrapping, all to be done. Unless you're done already, have a good start on all these things that we think are necessary for a great celebration. But as we focus on Christmas, let us not forget that even as we keep active in our waiting for this celebration, we are to remember that we also are waiting for Jesus' return. And so we wait with anticipation as we prepare. And while we wait, we use the gifts given to us by God, our spiritual gifts. Jesus said that we are to keep watch, for no one knows the hour. Not the angels in heaven, not even the Son, Jesus. Only the Father knows when Jesus will come again. Our instructions are to keep watch, to wait, to be awake, to pay attention, but to continue going about our tasks each day. We trust that God will take care of us,
leading us through whatever is going on in our lives. We gather together in this place. We hear the words of grace. We receive the sacraments. We confess our sins and hear the words, "You are forgiven." To stay alert, we communicate with God on a regular basis. Through our talks with Him, we call prayer. We remember those who are ill or homebound, those in nursing home and hospital. If we can't visit them, we can send cards. Call if they're able to visit by phone, and again, we can always pray. We do what we are called to do as a community and as an individual because of what God has done for us. And we wait. Mark gives us some advice about waiting and watching, being prepared. Jesus instructs his followers to keep watch for the coming of the kingdom. Recall that according to Luke 2, the shepherds were out in their fields keeping watch over their flocks by night when the angels announced the birth of Jesus to them. In contrast, the disciples were not able to keep watch with Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. They fell asleep, and the enemy caught them off guard. Jesus kept alert through the power of prayer and warns his disciples to keep watch so as not to be surprised. Keeping watch is one of the main themes of the season of Advent. The shepherds kept watch over their flocks when the angelic messengers heralded their activity. The wise men were watching the heavens and followed the star. In our gospel, Jesus warns us to keep watch for the kingdom. What do we do as we watch for Jesus' coming? For those who believe that Jesus is coming again, there are two responses, one passive and one active. The passive response can be called waiting, the active, watching. To understand the difference between the two, picture people living alone. Some are waiting for someone to stop by, waiting for someone to break the loneliness of their existence, to bring joy and love into their lives. But nobody comes, or only infrequently does a visitor appear. The waiter becomes passive. Then there are the watchers. They know someone is coming to see them. They may not know exactly when, but they know someone will come because they've come before and they can be relied upon. They are looking forward to the visit with great anticipation. They are anxious to fix themselves up and make their homes presentable. They rehearse what they might discuss. They want to make sure nothing will intrude on their visit. And then they watch, listen for the footsteps that they have come to recognize and to love. And because their lives have a forward view, they have a joy that they communicate to those about them. Rather than retreat into a shell, they reach out to others and tell them about the one who is coming. Jesus enjoins us not to merely wait for his coming, but to watch for it. In the Creed, we confess that Jesus was born, suffered, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell and 3 days later rose from the grave alive. 40 days later, he ascended into heaven, and we say that he will come again to judge those who are living and those who have died. We confess, "I believe." But do we pay attention to the words?
I know sometimes my mind wanders. I'm speaking the words, but then I realize I'm saying them by rote. So familiar with it that my mind is elsewhere. I often have to stop myself and remember I need to be stating what I believe, just as when I pray the Lord's Prayer. I need to pay attention to what I am praying. Paul tells us we will be blameless, not because of what we have done, but because of what Christ has done for us. This is grace, undeserved and given freely by the death and resurrection of Jesus. While we wait and watch, we go about our tasks, using our gifts that God has given to each and every one of us. Advent is a time of active waiting, watching, as we share the gifts of God with the world. Indeed, our entire Christian existence is one of actively and eagerly waiting and watching for the revealing of the glory of Christ. This season of Advent, listen for the themes of waiting, watching, being prepared. As the shepherds watched over the flocks, the Magi watched the heavens and followed a star. We do the same. We keep active watch, being vigilant, living in the hope and the assurance that we are saved through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Our song of the day is number 35 in our new hymnal.
With hope and expectation, we offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all who await God's day of restoration. Call your church into holy fellowship as we await the restoration of all things. Re-energize your faithful people to live with hope and compassion, especially those who serve as missionaries near and far. Center us on our promise to come among us and make all things new. Merciful God, receive our prayer. All creation signals your presence, O God. The vastness of the cosmos, the turn of the seasons, and living things that both rest and flourish. Rekindle our commitment to care for the earth. Merciful God,
receive our prayers.
Let the nations tremble at your holy presence. Let justice and liberation prevail in all corners of the earth. Restore peace to nations in conflict. Teach righteousness to corrupt leaders and systems, and bring stability to areas facing uncertain futures. Merciful God,
receive our prayers.
Enrich the spirits of all who feel hopeless, fearful, or despairing. Stay close to those who await healing or relief. We especially lift up Linda Fairbrother, Miles Pesa. We also remember the family of Frank Mosier, who died this past week. Bring comfort and peace to them. We also remember those we lift up in our hearts now or speak aloud. Deliver all in any need, merciful God.
Receive our prayer.
Be with those who keep awake at night, nurses working overtime shifts, caregivers of newborns and aging adults, stargazers, those who are anxious or those who are traveling. Reveal to all that the dark and the abyss of calm and comfort fill with your presence. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
You have sent out your angels and gathered your faithful people from every time and place, calling them into one fellowship of saints. Bless the witness of those who dwell in your eternal presence. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Listen to these and all our prayers, O God of hosts, and restore us with your great and everlasting mercy. Amen. The peace of Christ is with you always.
And also with you.
We share God's peace with each other at this time.
Thank you.
provider, by your merciful hand, abundance springs up of the earth. See, you bless these gifts of your own bounty. Let them be a sign of your steadfast love and faithfulness for all people. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. Save us from the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The God of peace bless you. The love of Christ sustain you in hope, and the anointing of the Spirit remain upon you now and forever. Amen. Amen. Our singing song is number 30 in our green hymnal.
Peace.